Today we're going to talk about the CZ-97B. It's a full-size 45, excellent for home defense. But I also want to talk about some similar guns and make some comparisons. I want to talk about my experience with CZ, a gun manufacturer out of the Czech Republic. They have a division here in America, out of Kansas City, and they're well known for their CZ-75. They have a ton of variants. They have a lot of higher-end variants. It's a 9mm pistol, hammer-fire pistol. Highly reliable. I actually had one. I had a Phantom one time, and that was actually a pretty reliable gun. I did a review on it. If I can find it, I'll put a link on it. Link in the description box. But today, I want to talk about CZ as a manufacturer and my thoughts and my experiences with it. I've never had an issue with this few CZs that I've had. If you guys have some experiences, definitely share it with me. This right here is a CZ-97B. Now, this is a 45 version of the CZ-75. This is, imagine CZ-75, but in a 45 ACP caliber. They actually offer a CZ-97BD, or D-cocker version. So that's something you can keep in mind if you want the D-cocker. This, both guns come with two magazines. The magazines are priced similarly to Sig, so keep that in mind. Speaking of Sig, a really obvious comparison would be the Sig Sauer P227 or P220, which is still being developed, still being sold in the United States. The P227 has actually been discontinued as well, but a comparison, they're both steel frame or the metal frame guns, okay? They're hammer fire guns. You can get a decocker for both versions. The CZ comes with a decocker version. You can definitely see a little bit different as far as the frames. You can switch out the grips. That's another similarity between the two guns. Some differences, well, you don't see any type of rail system up here. So if you're looking to put a light on there, this wouldn't be the gun for you. The Sig Sauer might be a better option. Magazines are pretty similar as far as quality. Both have a 10 round capacity. I've had really good experiences with the Sigs. But yeah, if you're looking for a light, that's going to be a disadvantage here with the CZ. But man, it's smooth. So smooth. So awesome. As far as being able to find accessories, you might have a little bit better luck with the Sig than you will with the CZ. And you get night sights with the Sig Sauer. Some people prefer that, some people prefer something different. Now if you want to look at similar guns, HK-45, also 10 round capacity, a little bit of a newer gun, made in the mid-2000s, the first decade of 2000s, I think, somewhere around 2007 or so. But it has a really great grip. The ergonomics are just hard to really compete with, and you also get a rail. So if you want to put a light on there, it's a lot easier with this type. It's newer design. The grips is just, the frame is just hard to really beat as far as a grip. That's really difficult to beat. You can get different variants for this one as well. So something to keep in mind. Now, of course, when you think of a full-size 45, you can't think about it without think about the capacity of the FNX 45 Tactical. Or FNX 45, 15 round capacity. Kind of hard to beat. 15 rounds is absolutely incredible. 15 rounds of 45. It also hammer fired as well. Has a safety decocker going for itself. Elevated sights. All right, night sights. Has a thread protector. You can put a suppressor on here. But the thing is, I think the build quality is probably superior. When I compare these two with the CZ, just my little humble opinion, I think this is is built a little bit better. One thing I don't like about this is that maybe you gotta put some Loctite in here or something, but this sort of rattles and it sort of comes loose. Sometimes this does as well. That's not too big of an issue, but definitely this. So now there's a safety on there. Once you deactivate the safety, then you can rack the slide. You see there's nothing inside. Magazine capacity 10, which is pretty standard now, but considering how big the gun is, you would hope that it would be maybe at least 12 rounds, especially when you have the Glock 21, which is my everyday carry, which is has a capacity of 13 plus one in the chamber. This is 10 plus one in the chamber. I don't look at it as being double stack, maybe one and a half stack. If you're looking for a 1911 alternative, then this might be a really good option. The CZ-97B, like I said, there is a decocker version. You cannot, well, let's see. Pretty much put it on safe right here, but take it off. The decocker version just goes down like this. But anyway, this is a hammer fire like the other CZ-75. This comes with sights that are fiber optic sights. So if you ever lose it, or you break it or something, always replace it. Grips, you know, this isn't a gun for a person with small hands. I'll put it that way. If your hands are small, this isn't a good idea for you. 45s generally isn't a great idea for somebody with small hands, especially not this one. But if you have medium-sized hands, you can probably manage this fairly well. I have very large hands, very long fingers, so this is pretty fine. This is pretty good for me. Not an issue at all. It's not too thick at all. These aluminum grips or whatever it was made out of, they feel pretty good in my hand. I don't think it takes up too much space. Magazine quality seems to be pretty good. The availability seems to be good. I think the gun is actually discontinued, so keep that in mind as well. Me and these discontinued guns. But anyway, it's definitely worth, if you have to go to the shooting range and you can rent one of these things out, then it's definitely worth checking out. One thing you might want to keep in mind is that it comes with a tool. I think it's designed to help you disassemble the gun. So it's not quite like a Glock. It's not as easy to disassemble as a Glock. So that's something you might want to keep in mind. I wish the capacity was a little bit greater. I think there's plenty of space inside here if you want to operate this with gloves. So that shouldn't be much of an issue right now. I love the front serrations right here. I love the fact they have lines coming in right here. So you don't have to worry too much about the glare. Rear serrations on the slide, some on the front, so it makes it easier for you to just grab that slide and rack it back. There's a little indicator, a little chamber indicator, which I don't really use. I just make sure I'm very mindful of whether there's something inside of it or not. So this, of course, is clear. You can change out the grips if you want to go with a different color or something a little fancy. That is an option you can go with. And I'll give you guys some range footage. My first 50 rounds shooting this thing. Take a look. A lot of A's, a couple of C's. More off to the left. Not good, but I've got something in this area better. As far as weight, this thing, it feels like a brick, but it's not too much for me. I will say that it handles recoil very, very well. I'm very impressed with that.
Not bad, I like it.
I love the way it shoots, man. It's something about these hammer fire guns. I'm really starting to love these hammer fire guns. I actually have more hammer fire guns than striker fire guns, if you can believe it. But yeah, that's the case. And I still love 45, as you can tell. I'm not gonna really get into 10 millimeter. I don't think it's really justified, especially if I don't live in a area like Alaska or Montana or a rural area where I have to worry about large game. So anyway, guys, share your thoughts and experiences with these type of, with this manufacturer. For this gun right here, it might be a good home defense gun. I don't know about carry. It's just, you know, to carry it, I would rather carry something with a greater capacity if I'm going to carry a large gun like this. Just something to keep in mind. But you can carry it cocked and locked. That's definitely an option. But home defense, definitely a good option. I love the way it shoots the trigger. It seems to be fairly smooth. Definitely recommend it. So thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Go for the head. Work for that. Hey, headshot. Miss, got a C, miss there. Got some A's and some C's right in here.